Hey everyone, Brian here. We're going to go over quickly today how to install RenderMan for Blender. It's a little bit more involved than just installing one package because it's an add-on to Blender. But we'll go through it pretty quickly here and hopefully get everyone started. So the first thing to do is to download and install Blender itself. Maybe this is obvious, and most of you probably already have Blender installed on your machine. But just to make sure that everyone's up to speed, I'm downloading Blender from blender.org and installing it here. I already have it installed, and all I'm just going to do is do a quick render with a cycle just to make sure it's working and everything's all set before we go ahead. So now that we see that Blender's working, the next step is going to be to download RenderMan NCR from the site renderman.pixar.com. I'll put links to all this below in the notes. You're going to need to sign up for an account at renderman.pixar.com and look for the link that says Get RenderMan or the Get NCR. And after you've been signed up for an account, it will let you download. Here, right now it says version 20, but you want version 21, which will be the default after we release 21's NCR version. So you just have to enter some info. We're not taking any, putting you on a mailing list for RenderMan, but we just want to know who's downloading the software and using it. So after you've registered for the site and entered your info here, we're going to be able to, it's going to download an installer for RenderMan. And that installer is going to give you all the options of NCR versions that you can install. And it's also going to install your NCR license for you. So it's going to take care of everything for you. But first you have to enter all your info here, and I'm just going ahead and going to do that. And go enter the CAPTCHA and then hit next. And then that will ask me to download the NCR installer. So first you download the installer, and then you actually will the installer will actually install RenderMan for you. So enter your info here. It's important to remember, if you haven't already signed up for your forums, RenderMan forums here, you'll have to do that before you actually get access to the installer. Okay, so now I have my installer here, so I'm going to run the installer, which is going to download RenderMan Pro Server for you. Unfortunately, you do have to be connected to the internet here to do this. And again, you're going to have to enter your forum username that you signed up for previously. I'm not going to go through the signing up for the form process, but that should be pretty standard. Okay, so after you've entered your forum information, I actually put in the wrong one here, but after you put in the forum information, it's going to download a license for you, and that's the first step for getting the software. Is getting the license, but this should all be automatic. So just put in your information and do this. Okay, so here we are, where it's actually letting us choose which software we want to install. If you hit the Show All button here at the bottom, it'll give you a list of options of what you can install. I'm just choosing RenderMan Pro Server. For RenderMan for Blender, all you need is the Pro Server. But if you have Maya, you can install RenderMan for Maya as well. You don't need RenderMan for Maya. In previous versions of the Blender add-on, you needed RenderMan for Maya as well. Now you don't need it, so you can get away with just doing the RenderMan Pro Server, and it's a tiny, tiny install. The important thing here is, to make everything easy, it's good to let it install to the normal location. If you want to install to, your D drive on Windows or somewhere else, you can do that, but it's going to make the setup process a little more tedious when you go and try to turn on the add-on in Blender. So keep that in mind. It's not a huge install. It's only about a couple hundred megabytes. And I would recommend just putting it in the default location. Okay, so we got our RenderMan Pro server installed. The next step here is to download the add-on from the GitHub page for the Blender add-on. And actually, it's good to go and check to make sure. Here, I'm on OS X, and if you go and look at your application's Pixar directory, you should see RenderMan Pro Server 21.2 installed for you. And I have a lot of different versions here because I'm working on the software, but we're just checking to make sure that's there. But again, so we're going back to download the add-on from the GitHub page, and you'll have a couple places you can get from the releases page. You'll want to get the 21.2 version. Don't get the 20.11 version. If you're using 21 NC version of RenderMan, you want to get the version of the add-on that matches the version of RenderMan that you got. So you can download that right from the releases page is where the stable versions are coming from. So that will download as a zip file. After you download that zip file, we're going to do is go into Blender and install it like any other add-on in the user preferences in Blender. So I'm just going to put that zip file on my desktop here, go and start my Blender. After I start Blender, I'm going to go into the user preferences for Blender. Oops, started the wrong version of Blender there. Hold on. All right, here we go. So this is a new version of Blender I've downloaded. I'm going to go into my user preferences now. And then in the user preferences, you'll see this button at the bottom that says install add-on from file. One good thing to check is in your add-ons to make sure there's not another version of RenderMan for Blender already installed. Sometimes they can overlap if you have two versions of them installed. But if you just update from an old one, usually they'll override each other. So I installed it from the zip file here, and then you just click this button and it enables. It looks like we're all set here. If you were installing from a different location, you can choose the version here of where to get it from, and also let you choose which version you want to do. You can leave this all to default. It should take care of it for you, unless you're installing to a different location rather than the normal C:\ program files on Windows or application/Pixar on OS X. One thing to note is after installing RenderMan on Windows, you might have to restart. But it's only on Windows because it needs to update the environment variables. Okay, so now we have our add-on installed, and we're just going to test it out here and hit render, and then we get our cube, our default cube from Blender rendered fine. One thing I like to use is we have a image buffer called it that comes with RenderMan, and I think it's more useful than using the render view inside of Blender. So if we switch that here in the render preferences, we'll be able to render straight to it and get a faster update of our display. And that's just because of the way that files are handled in Blender. It doesn't go exactly with RenderMan. The other thing is we have an interactive renderer. So if we turn on the IPR render, much like the rendered view in the viewport, we'll be able to change our lights and camera and move things around. So that's about it. If you have any questions, post them below. And happy rendering. Thanks.